Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In previous video, couple of videos, we have learned how we can make use of the Spring Boot cache integration. And in this video, I'll continue with the same example. And in whatever things we have learned in the previous video, there is a problem with the caching. So thing is that if you look into the method, is called get ticket by ID. And basically there is some loophole, there is some problem over here. So when you ask by providing the ID, right, then if that entry is already available in the cache which we have defined over here with the specified key ticket ID, then that gets returned to you. But if you ask for the ticket information with the ID which is not available at all in the underlying data store, still that is going to cache with that, that is again to going to cache that ticket information in the cache with the null value. So here in this video we'll talk how do I tell Spring cache not to cache null values while using the @rate cacheable annotation. So first of all, let me reproduce that issue which is present in this code. So if you go to the database, then currently I have a 4 records in my database, and here is the browser. Let's try to see the, let's access this matrices and see what is the current size of cache. So saying that current size of cache is 0. Now let's try to access one element whose ID is 2. Then first time, of course, this is going to hit the database, right? So let's clean this, and this will put in the cache. And if you see the cache size, then that is 1. If you ask for the same result, then at this time this is not going to hit the database because that is already present in the cache. That's why there is no select query. But if you ask for the ticket information whose ID is 3, and that is that we got, and again cache size would be increased, right? Now 2. So as we have accessed this ticket information first time, that's why that is going to hit the underlying database. If I clean this, and if I ask for the same ticket information, then that is not going to hit the underlying data store, right? And that's why there is no select query, right? Now I'm asking to my API to return a ticket whose ID is 30, but that ticket does not exist at all in our database, right? Still this is gonna increase the cache side, that is wrong, right? That return nothing, right? So if you go to the here, then cache size still should be 2, but if you rephrase, then saying the cache size is 3. If you ask for the again 40 70, then cache size is keep increasing, right? So basically that will putting the different entry with null values with different keys, right? So how to fix this problem? So I'm going to kill this server, right? And I'm going to clean the database. I'm going to drop this table, and here we'll have to use something is called conditional cache. Here we'll have to specify something is called unless. In unless condition, we will have to specify. You can make use of result equal to null, and this will fix your issue. Now let's this project. Let's run this project, and in beginning, our script is going to run schema.sql, which contains the DDL query to create our database table. And data.sql which holds some insert query so that we can populate some record in the database as well. So you can see table is again got created, and there is 4 records. Now after fixing this issue, let's run this program again and go to matrices. And if you invoke this endpoint, then you will see currently cache size is 0. if you ask for the element, let's say I'm going to ask for the ticket information which ID is 2, then that got returned to us and cash size is increased by 1, right? Now ask for the 3, then cash size would be 2. Now I'm going to ask for the ticket whose ID is 30. That what we are expecting, as we know that 30 does not exist in our database, so that should not be cached. Now we got nothing. If you go a refresh, then size is still 2. That means that issue got fixed. Now ask for the ticket whose ID is 50, then still cache size should be 2 only, right? Because ticket with ID 50 doesn't exist in our database, right? So this issue got fixed. So that's all I wanted to discuss in this video tutorial, guys. So thanks for watching this video and see you next video tutorial.